If you're a React developer, you might have found yourself stuck in one of these situations where you want your code to react to user events, but because they happen very often, you want to optimize them. If you're creating a chat, for example, you might have your current message stored in a state that gets updated on every keystroke, and when the user's ready, they can send their final message through our onSend function here. Now, let's focus on the code. When it comes to optimization, you could obviously wrap onSend with useCallback to make sure the function only gets recreated when your state changes. And this is great because now input will not re-render unless onSend gets recreated. At the same time, this optimization is not exactly what we would hope for because onSend will be recreated every single time your message changes. Now, you could actually fix this using a reference. With some boilerplate, sendRef here will store our event handler so that onSend will always be the same function you're passing down to input. Well, although this could work, you're losing a lot in code readability. The good news is, this is almost exactly what the useEvent React hook does. Let's refactor our code with it. Now, if we go back to what we usually write in React applications, the main difference lies in the number of re-renders that will happen here. With useCallback, we'll recreate a new function when the message changes, and input will re-render every time it does. With useEvent, however, will only trigger one rendering on component mount. Again, the reason is that the function onSend will always be the same, and that's even the reason why we could drop the dependencies entirely. In terms of what useEvent returns, it behaves just like a normal function. So you could also pass it arguments like a room ID and call it inside input as you normally would. useEvent is very useful for handlers, events that you will also find a lot inside useEffects. If we go back to our chat example, let's say we want to show a success alert and empty our current message when we're changing chat rooms. This works okay, but if our toast reads from our current theme context, we will need our effect to add it as a dependency, which in turn would break it. We just don't want a toast to appear whenever our theme changes. Again, this could be taken outside of the effect, converted to a callback. But useEvent would just make more sense here, since it will prevent unnecessary re-renders if the function is passed onto a component, and also clarify our code as to what that function is for. Alright, I hope you found this interesting. If you're curious, you can read more about useEvent on Dan Abramov's RFC. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.